Said, what happened to him? He used to talk about things. He said, leave homosexuality alone. Leave lesbianism alone. Leave them alone. I can't leave them alone. I want to see them saved. I want to see them delivered. I want to see them free. Reason Christianity is not growing in America, that's growing. It's growing. It's growing in other countries. But America has become a post-Christian nation. I'm saying that based on the fact that it's not growing. When you run polls, fewer people attend church. Fewer and fewer people, we know how to change the chairs, attend the convocations, the workers' meetings. Well, I don't care whether it's national or jurisdictional, whatever. We're having less and less influence on people. Our singers want to pretend that they're hip-hop stars. Our preachers want to preach in jeans and t-shirts. Whatever the nomenclature or the talk is in the world, it finds its way in the church. They influence us much more than we influence them. And the reason that this is happening, I believe, is because we stop preaching grown man, grown woman messages. We begin to spend all our time trying to be motivational speakers. Every sermon's got to be about you coming out, God giving you something, excusing your wickedness. God's gonna judge you. God's gonna judge all. If you don't believe me, watch and see. About things like this, I'm never wrong. Never. Daniel could have done it. But he said no. And ended up in the den of lions. And to me, the most powerful scripture in the Bible, one of the ones that nothing gives me joy. Like the next morning, the king got up, looked into the lion's den and called in there and said, oh, Daniel, was your God able to protect you, to keep you in the lion's den? Then the next verse says, then said Daniel. Then said Daniel. Let me tell you something. Our God is a keeper. But you got to take a stand. You got to need to be kept. We almost need to stop preaching, come out from among them, because we done changed and allowed so much in the church that there's not much to come out of anymore. I'm almost through. Yeah, he prayed. He said, Lord, I need discernment. I need understanding. We struggle when people now call this type of preaching mean. We lack discernment. Our lives are struggling. Our homes are struggling because of just a series of bad decisions. We can't manage a church service, can't manage a wallet, can't manage a relationship, can't make a good decision on a song, can't just discernment, the ability to know this from that, the ability to judge, to make distinctions. Let me tell you something. Don't you let anybody talk you out of. Sutherland, don't let anybody talk you out of distinguishing between right and wrong. It'll rob you of your joy. Your light will go out. You sit there and you can't even get into service. You'll look like a different person. Yeah. The devil's getting to you then. Yeah. Now he's got you questioning.
Yeah. Come on,
I'm not doubting about the way. Walking in the light, holiness is right. And I'm not doubting about the way. God, give me discernment. Every path. The late, great Otis Lockett said something. Well, he said many things. I quote him quite a bit. He said one day, he got along with God and he said to the Lord, and I incorporated this in my quiet time. He said to God, Lord, where am I carrying these people? I've asked God, upper room, NC Third, God, where am I carrying these people? They listen to me. They trust me. For the most part, they're following me. Where am I leading them? The one and said, are we really doing your will? See, we're in a world today. We're in a world today where the church has endorsed sin. We endorse it. We say we're not, but we're doing it. This is a different day. There's no conviction. Perverts walk around our services. Men walk around now in the holy national services dressed like women. And no one says a word. And you know what? They ain't afraid. They're not ashamed. And look online, and lo and behold, they've taken a picture and standing there grinning beside them is a supervisor or a bishop. Or a leader. Pervert walked up to me when they said, Bishop Wooden, can I take a picture with you? Will you take a picture with me? I said, I will not.
No.
We were in the lobby of a hotel. Now, when people hear this, they think I'm mean. I'm not being mean. I love the young man. He said, why? I said, because you're standing there. You're much taller than me. I said, man, you'd make some woman a great husband, some kids a great dad, but you're standing there with a woman's top on, a female brooch on, you dressed like a girl. No, I can't take a picture with you. For you, for him to post that, what they say, a picture worth a thousand words.
That's right.
Mm-mm. I had discernment. Then I saw him again at the next national meeting. And he had kind of improved a little bit. He said, will you take a picture with me now? I said, I will not. The Holy Spirit said he's not ready. So that was designed to deceive me. I saw him a day or two later in the same meeting. I saw him before he saw me. He was dressed like a stone girl. And I walked up to him. I said, hey, come here. Come here. See, that's why I wouldn't take the picture. See. No. Jesus died for him. You can't win people going along with their wickedness. The Bible says that we're to put a difference. Now, I know some of you pastors, you don't believe in putting a difference, and you'll stand before God on it. But the Bible said that we're to put a difference between holy and unholy. I'm a little too flat, sir. Holy and unholy, clean and unclean. Amen. Solomon prayed for understanding. Look at what he prayed for. I'm almost done. A heart to judge thy people. That I might discern. Help me to discern between good and bad. For who is able to judge this thy so great a people? They're great people. I want to lead them right, oh God. I need discernment. Verse 10 said the speech pleased the Lord. God responded and God said, because thou hast asked this thing, and you didn't ask for long life, you didn't ask for riches for yourself, and you didn't ask for the death of your enemies, but thou hast asked for thyself an understanding and to discern judgment, to know the difference, to know how to talk, to know how to speak to issues, to know what you need to preach about. Some of us major in minors. We minor in majors. The new sin is not sin. The new sin in the church world, listen at these preachers online. The new sin is they preach against the preacher who preach against sin. They don't preach against sin. They preach against the preacher who preach against sin. God's going to judge you all. God's going to do that. You preached against my servant. But my servant was saying what the word said. Y'all saw how the whole church world turned on churches that just wanted to stay open during COVID. So you bring that up again. I'm going to bring it up. Until I die. We were accused of being insensitive, silly, unbelieving. Somebody said Wooden is trying to tempt God. How can you try to tempt God doing what God said? We dropped the BIBLE for the CDC. We replaced Jesus with Tony Fauci. And the church hadn't been the same since. And some of these preachers, all of them complaining, I can't get my folk to come back to church. That's because you talked them out of it. You talked them out of it. They trusted you. You went too far. You did too good of a job. All their saved life, you were telling them how important it is to attend church. Then you, same voice, same organ player, same suit, same mic, preached and told your people, don't come back here. This place is not safe. And by the way, on your way home, stop by Walmart. Go by the box stores. Go by Target. Y'all not saying anything now. On your way home. And I said, then real time, you're going to talk people into doing something that's going to be hard to talk them out of. And then when it was time to open, the saints said, we like streaming. I like watching you, preacher, from my easy chair. With my foot up. My coffee. I hope it's coffee. But you talked them into that. As you criticized the soldiers. But what about those who died? They went home to be with the Lord. We used to believe that God controls stuff like that. I better speed up.